Sabhai Namaha. Though Buddha Manji told that fears are vanishing from all of you, but I am terribly afraid because taking the dais after Buddha Manji speaks is very difficult. So let me first chant a mantra, and I expect that all of you will be repeating after me. It's from the Devi Mahatmyam. Sarvasvarupe Sarveshe Sarvashakti Samanvite भये भस्त्राहिनो देवी दुर्गे देवी नमोस्तुते दुर्गे देवी नमोस्तुते। सो इट इज अ प्रेयर टू देवी ऑलमाइटी डिवाइन मदर। यू आर इन ऑल द फॉर्म्स। You are the possessor of all powers. Save us from all kinds of fears. I will start by giving two examples. The first example is of a girl who had completed her IIM from Ahmedabad. She belonged to a family of engineers. Even she says that from my neighborhood, they were well known because we had sent many to IITs and other engineering, noted engineering colleges throughout India. So my father also had a dream that she will also shine as one of the software engineers. But this girl had a knack for literature. And she had a great desire that her article should be published in the Times of India. She tried once, sent the article, and to her disappointment, it was not there in the issue. Second time she tried, it was not there. Like that, she says, she tried 40 times. And 41st time, it came in the Times of India, and for that, she was given 50 rupees. Who was the girl? She is Reshmi Bansal. Many of you might have heard her name, a noted writer. Many of her famous books, Stay Hungry, Stay Foolish, Connect the Dots, I Have a Dream. So here we find that though she underwent so many defeats, but she didn't lose hope. Guru Maharaj, Sri Ramakrishna, says in the famous parable, the person wants to dig a well, they try little, then sand comes, they leave it, go another place. Then another place they try, little they dig, rock comes, they leave it. But we have to take up one thing and go on digging in the same place, then water will come. So that grit, that is very, very important. And Sri Ramakrishna depicts it from small parables. Same thing, what we find, that failures can be treated as experiences, which will be bringing the inner talent out. That is more important. This is the first example of this kind. Now you go to the second one. Last year there was Uttarakhand tsunami, you all might remember, 2013. And there were many donations coming to the mutt. One such request came from the Advocate Welfare Society. And they invited, Swamiji, we have a small function, and in that we want to present a 5 lakhs check to you. Some representative from the mutt can come and collect that check. I was blessed enough that I had gone, it was nearby, and in that there was a famous lyricist. In Telugu movies, he's very famous, Suddala Ashok Teja. He's from Nalgonda, all of you know, and he was there in that program as the chief guest. He was in the dais. After this brief program of giving the check, I was sitting there and I was listening to his talk, telling about his life. He had got the National Film Fair Award also in 2003. And in the same dais, there was the Chief Justice. There was other noted judges sitting there, gracing the occasion. And this person was there. He was telling, I, after my intermediate, had gone with an interview seeking with an appeal to join as a lower division clerk in the court. Now I am in the 50s. If I would have got that, I didn't get it. My appeal was rejected. I didn't get it. If I would have got that, I might have been promoted to a senior division clerk, that's all, and I would have retired like that. But he says in his own Telugu style, naturally, he says that God had closed one window for me, but he opened a Simhadwaram. Oka kitiki mushesharu, but God had opened one big door for me. And now, today, I am here as the chief guest, and the chief justice is there, other judges are there. If I would have been selected as an employee in the court, I would have never got this opportunity. Just imagine. Agate swagatam kuriyat gachamtam na nivarayat. This particular thing, again, we'll take up a small analogy. What is this? What actually happens? What is the difference between failure and success? It is raining. Just imagine it is raining. One among you, take up anyone. You are there. You are running towards the shed. It's raining heavily. Suddenly, none of us carries umbrella in Hyderabad. We never expect a rain. Suddenly started raining. You go to a small bus stop and you go and stand there. There may be other people also standing there. Some two boys are there. No one is bothered about the rain, but they are bothered about their own worries. The two boys, they start talking. Oh, see, it is raining. Today, I think, whole day gone, spoiled. Our all plans of going to the movie has been cancelled now. We can't do anything. Then another couple was there, an old man and his wife. The old man scolds the wife. See, I told you, bring the umbrella. You didn't listen to me. Always. Now, wives will never listen to the husband. That's quite common. So, you never listen to me. I told you, you bring the umbrella, but you didn't bring it. Now we have to wait here. We'll get delayed. And another boy was there who has taken out a note and he was trying to dry that note. His 20 rupees note had got wet with the rain. He was trying to dry that note. And one person, the hero, say, I will not take the name, is standing there. Also, he also came to the shed to get away from the rain, to save himself from the rainwater, all are standing. Suddenly he notices one father comes with a small kid, the kid holding one of the hand of the kid and the father one hand on his head, and he's bringing the kid. Now all attention, the kid is drawing. What the kid is doing? Naturally, the children's behavior are very attractive. The kid is taking the water and playing with the water. And somehow the father drags and comes to the shed, makes a place. Father is still holding the hand of the kid. And with one hand, he's doing something in the cell phone, typing a message. But the kid still is going out, taking the rainwater in her hand and drinking it, playing with the water. All the entire concentration is on the kid now. She is going on doing this. Suddenly she stops and she asks her father, why does not it rain every day? Why doesn't it rain every day? Ha, it will rain, don't worry. Again she asks, no father, why does not it rain every day? But she didn't get any reply. But we can take the reply, we can get the answer for the difference. What is the difference between a person who has failed and who has succeeded? See, it's very simple, we can explain it. When rain falls, does it make any difference between high and low, black or white, between male and female, between the caste, between the creeds, between any country? It falls. In a similar way, among all, falls upon all of us. Similarly, that cosmic power, that energy is falling like rain on all of us. It is falling upon us. But what is the difference? If we cover ourselves like this, then it touches us and falls away. And if we put our hands like this, then it falls, you drink it, you become more strong and able to face all the failures. The thing is, the difference lies here. Rain is falling upon all of us. If we cover ourselves, that cosmic power, that energy, you can give it the name of Brahman, power, supernatural power, energy, whatever you may call it. It is pouring upon all of us. Some are covering themselves, some are taking it. Drinking that, becoming more strong and facing all the failures, making a success out of it. Agate swagatam kuriyat gacchantam na nivarayet. Let it come. Whatever is happening is for the good only. And you see, one more thing the child was doing. Again and again he was doing something. What? He was questioning. He was asking his father. What we do in our childhood days? Every day we have thousands of questions. But as we grow elder, in 1,000 days also we don't ask a question. Do we ask ourselves, why I am here, what I am doing, what is my goal? No, we don't bother about any time to ask a question that what I am doing, what is my goal? Ultimately, what is the role? Who am I? Do we ever think? Anytime we get some free time, and now this cell phone is immense, always we are with it. We are never alone. Asking questions to ourselves. The day we stop asking questions, that day our growth stops. We fail to understand what is failure, what is success. You just see a person who is successful, he will have only questions. And a person who has failed, he will have only worries, he will have only excuses, he will go on whining, oh, this problem. But questions will come from only the persons who think, why I'm doing, what is ahead of me, what is my goal? And ultimately, what Sri Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita? Sri Krishna says, ए यथा माम प्रपद्यन्ते तांस तथैव भजाम्यहम् मम वर्तमानुवर्तन्ते मनुष्या पार्थ सर्वशः ए यथा माम प्रपद्यन्ते whosoever comes to me through whatsoever form I reach him all men are struggling through paths which in the end lead to me. Swamiji quotes this in his first Chicago address, 11 September 1893. He says, famous shloka from the Bhagavad Gita, that all of us ultimately our goal is, all of our spiritual aspirants here, all of us know, manushya janma is for Bhagavat Sakshatkar. And ultimately, whatever we are doing, the ultimate result is either in this birth or in the births to come, we will reach that ultimate goal. We don't know when it will come, but we are on the track. 1,25,000 yonis are there, right from the unicellular amoeba to human beings. You do some good work, you go down again you come back. But ultimate growth, evolution theory says that, what is this? This also, can we say it is a failure? No, we are growing, we are progressing slowly. So failures are again in our own evolution theory, our death, birth, reincarnation, whatever you may call it, it is also, we are slowly progressing, stepping stones towards the success. So if we just sum up, we say, na, what you take back after all the provident fund and gratuity cuttings, you take back some salary. So if you see, if we sum up, then we saw two examples. One is of the lady, Reshmi Bansal. She tried so much, but her dream came true after 40 trials. But she didn't give up. And another of this Dala Shokteja, who didn't give up. He went on studying more. That time he was in problem. He complained, I didn't get. But afterwards he says, see, I am in this position now. Many other examples are there. We can note them. But see, two different aspects. One is, she went on trying. This fellow took it. Yes, I accept what God has given for me. Agate swagatam kuriyat gacchantam na nivarayat. Let it come. If it is coming, I accept it. It is for my good. Whatever God is doing is for our good. Fair and unfair. We many times complain, the situations are unfair, Swamiji. The unfairness is to bring out the fairness in us. The problems come not to break us, but to make us more strong, make us more humble. Ego crushing, messy. We have so much ego, so much I-ness. Sometimes someone will say something, but for that, if we get depressed and go, and disrespect others, shout, fall in the Hussain Sagar, take something. So many cases, so many social problems are coming nowadays just for these simple failures and successes. And ultimately we saw that falling of the rain. Like the rain is falling among all of us. Maybe I'm in the stage, you are there. That Lord's power, what is his power? You can see, Vizag, what happened? That cyclone, Hudud cyclone, how much havoc it created. In 1 second it can destroy this whole universe. And in 1 second it can again create it. That is its power. We say that I am doing, he is doing, he is doing. We may be doing hardly 10% or 2%, but take away 90% credit. We want that credit. And when we don't get, oh, company is not acknowledging me, Swamiji. Even our body functions, how much we take. Digestion, breathing, all of you are breathing now. Do you breathe with concentration? Only when Bodhamayanji has to sit and meditate. When we meditate, we have to practice that. Otherwise, it is going on. So many processes in our body goes on without our notice, without our knowledge. Similar is the case. On everyone, this power is working. This cosmic power, you may call it God, you may call it Brahman, give it any other name, but it is working on all of us. Those whose hands are like this, they will never get the help of it. If your hands are like this, and in the childhood, our hands were like this only when we were born. But slowly some hands went up, some remained like this. The hands which are like this is a successful person. The hands which went up, we call them failures. Because we are not ready to accept the situations that are coming in our life. So we'll again end with a prayer from Devi Mahatmyam. And I expect that all of you will repeat after me.
Etatte vadanam saumyam. Lochanatraya bhushitam. Patuna sarvabhitibhya. कात्यायनि नमोस्तुते पातु नः सर्वभीतिभ्यः कात्यायनि नमोस्तुते.
So again praying to Divine Mother that you are all powerful, you are almighty. Please release us from all kinds of fears, tensions, worries.
ॐ शांति 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 हरि ओम तत्सत् श्री राम कृष्णार्पणमस्तु.